had a very strong showing yesterday's debate, but prior to getting on the stage, Senator Fred Thompson and his wife, Jerry, stopped by my radio show, and they took questions during an hour-long special that we called Ask Fred. Take a look.
I think one of the great debate moments in this entire process is when the woman was asking a question, show of hands, you said, well, I'm not doing that today. And then he said, well, would you like me to answer the question? And you said, well, I'm not going to answer it. Because in a sense, these are real important consequential issues we're talking about.
Yeah.
And you can't break it down into a 10-second answer or a yes or no answer.
Yeah. These are, with all due respect to everybody concerned, these are exchanges of sound bites for the most part. There is no forum in this entire process for a sit-down discussion, a Lincoln-Douglas type thing, where you sit down and discuss and go back and forth and probe the details of an issue and the level of a person's thinking. And that's unfortunate. But out in Iowa, you know, there's more symbolism there, I guess, than meets the eye. There comes a point when a person's got to decide whether or not there should be some things beneath the dignity of even a presidential candidate. And, you know, it cuts you to a minute, it cuts you to 30 seconds, and then even that's too long. And say, we're going to throw some things at you, you know, the future of civilization, you know, and show of hands. And I said, I ain't doing that.
Yeah.
And, you know, it was like, what? What do you mean? You can't not do that. I said, well, I'm not doing it. I said, well, you give me a minute to answer that.
It's an important issue.
It's an important issue. Oh, no, can't do that. I said, well, then I'm not asking. And, you know, when I did that, the other guys took their hands down. You know, they lined up with me, and nobody's asked anybody to raise their hand since.
Yeah. All right, we start in Oklahoma City, Oklahoma.
How do you plan on recapturing the popularity and the focus from the media and the public that you had when you first announced that you were running?
Well, I appreciate that question. That's a legitimate question. I think, first of all, with regard to the last few days, all the attention's been New Hampshire, and I wasn't really competing in New Hampshire, so it's pretty much of an afterthought there, except for those debates, and even the debate questions a lot were oriented toward those guys who were competing the strongest in New Hampshire in terms of time and that sort of thing is concerned. Going back a little bit, you know, we kind of went from zero to a good third place finish in Iowa. I was looking at all the experts a couple of nights before in Iowa, and the only one that I saw, I mean, the only program that I saw had several experts giving their opinion as to who was going to come in third. And, of course, half of them got it wrong as to who would be first and second anyway, but they all picked John McCain. And then, of course, when that didn't work out that way, and I beat John by a bit, you know, it was kind of an afterthought. So, you know, everybody thinks, I guess, they get unfair treatment. We all go through a process, I think. They build you up to take you down and that sort of thing. But a lot of people have had to go through this process. Rudy was the inevitable one, you know, and now he's kind of an afterthought in some respects and struggling to make his case for a later strategy. You know, Mitt was going to take the first two primaries, primary and caucus, and of course he didn't, and he's lost out a little bit. You know, McCain was given up for dead. Now he's the comeback kid. You know, it's a different story every day. You've got to maintain yourself and your integrity through a process like this. I ran because of what I believe and my concern about the future of the country and the kind of world my kids and grandkids are going to grow up in. I have been a strong, consistent conservative all my career. I've stood strong for those positions. I feel like I have some integrity in the eyes of the American people, that I speak directly and truthfully, even sometimes when the truth is not to be very well received in terms of having to do things about our entitlement programs, which are bankrupting our nation and need to be reformed. And you know, if you're bobbing and weaving and trying to change your strategy all the time and your message all the time and even your positions all the time, like so many of these guys have, you lose yourself. And that's no way to become president. I mean, you got to be who you are and what you are and have faith in the American people. I still feel that not only is the right thing to do, but is the best strategy.
So another question for Jerry Thompson on the Sean Hannity Show. Brad, how are you?
Sean, you're a righteous American, brother.
Thank you, my friend. Welcome aboard.
Thank you. Senator Thompson, I think you're a stud and a true gentleman. my question is actually for your wife, Mrs. Thompson.
Yes, sir.
Yes, ma'am. I was just curious if the senator is as calm and reserved as I see him on TV at the home front, the House.
He actually is. He's actually very introverted. I think some folks think that a lot of politicians are kind of slappy on the back kind of guys. Fred really isn't. In fact, he fights most time to try to get away so he can have some time to think and to read. And he's very calm. He's very deliberative. He wears no man's collar, and sometimes that irritates some folks in the media. And he wanted to do this his way because he thought it was the right way. And what you see is what you get. And he's an amazing man, and I love him.
Wow, I think we better stop
it
right there.
Can we quit
right there? That's it, right there.